Welcome to Flash Gordon, the official story of the film podcast. This series will look behind the scenes of the forthcoming book that celebrates the making of the movie from 1980. I'm filmmaker and author John Walsh, and I will take you on a journey through time and space to discover how Flash Gordon has become one of the most iconic science fiction films in the last 40 years. I will be speaking with the cast and the crew and fans of the film and giving you an insight into the making of the book. I will reveal details of forthcoming events, and there'll be a chance to win copies of the book too. This could be a bumpy ride, so for God's sake, strap yourselves down!
Some features, John.
Thank you, Brian. It's very kind of you to say.
Yes. You make a very good Flash Gordon.
Well, thank you very much for coming on to say hello. And you've received your copy of Flash Gordon, the official story of the film.
Yes, I've got it here. Look, there, Major. I've got it here. I have to say, John, that it is left me breathless. It's absolutely sensational. I mean, there are all kinds of magazines and photographs have been taken of it, but this is sensational. It's history. I mean, all the stuff that are going back, you know, with Semple and people like that, and you know, with Dino, the whole history of it, etc., from that to Queen and Brian and all of them, and then the cast. It's amazing, and all the kind of infinite variety. I mean, this my Sky Palace. I mean, the whole scenery looks wonderful, presented wonderfully in the book. I mean, it's a treasure house, and all the secret stuff you put in, and wonderful things like the end of the film, the several endings, which are very intriguing. All those different endings. I think the ending's perfect. With Ming disappearing in the ring, but there are all kinds of endings there. I was sad to read here that Malangella, Melato, Gascala is no longer with us.
General Kala, Flash Gordon approaching.
What do you mean, Flash Gordon approaching?
On a Hawkman rocket cycle. Shall I inform His Majesty?
Imbecile! The Emperor would shoot you for interrupting his wedding with this news. Fire when Gordon's in range.
That's a real shame, isn't it?
My daughter and I, it was one of our favourite performances. She's quite wonderful, isn't she? Mm-hmm. We don't want to hurt you. A beautiful style. But I think we're lucky in the film. I mean, it sounds very vain. But to have actors actually who understand style. I mean, of course, you're taking first and foremost Ming, there are with Max. It was interesting that it covers all this in the book. You're going to detail with sets, you're going to detail with spaceships and the color and certain the skies. And because in Star Wars, the skies were black. And here we had all these multicolored wonderful skies, you know, pink and blue and green, etc. The costumes, I think, are absolutely amazingly good. And everybody gives a great performance in his own way. The comic strip, as the originator said, is a great art form. It is crass nonsense that people... you know, say the film is camp. That is a load, pardon my language, a load of bollocks. It's not camp. It has wonderful style, wonderful comic strip style, which is perfection. And the music, like the production, is beatific. I mean, you get the most romantic music at the beginning when they're in the rocket, and they're not, Dale and Flash are unconscious. And therefore, they fall against each other. And you get that lovely, almost string esoteric sound of romance inside the rock. Boom, boom. And they're slightly sweating as they're unconscious and rolling together. I would say, for my money, that's one of the most romantic scenes in the history of cinema. The entrance, you know, into the tunnel of fire and so forth, is again beatific. I did ask Dino, of course, to put the original Flash Gordon in the film, because as a child living in Yorkshire in Goldthorpe between Doncaster and Barnsley, we had our two cinemas, and we raced every weekend in the afternoon to see another episode of Buster Crabbe as Flash Gordon, and it was so scintillating, strange music in the back. Very sinister all the time on Mongo, a different electrical sound.
His Majesty, King Walton.
She is recovering, sir.
What has been done with the lion man who was captured with her?
Oh, he was revived and sent to the atom furnace, as your Majesty ordered.
And afterwards, we'd race out to the cinema and we'd go down the embankment. And I would always pretend to be Voltron. And I'd jump, you know, 12, 15 feet off a bloody bridge into bushes and sprain my left ankle bloody badly. Still a bit weak today. I was thrilled to play the part and felt very made, you know. I knew all the stunt men. I'd kill them millions of times in television things like The Three Musketeers. I'd spent my life killing half of them. But the cast got on wonderfully well, you know. Though I must say the director was a tough guy.
And yeah, Mike Hodges, yeah.
Mike Hodges, yeah. A really tough lad.
Yeah.
Great director, great vision. Look at the films he's done, you know, Get Carter and so forth. But he and I got on like a house on fire. When it came to scenes with the rocket, when we made our attack on Mingo City and we started to move in, all those fight scenes where the rocket, all the Hawkmen are flying down and all the goons are firing at us, all the guards are firing at us, suddenly the day came to film all that. We'd been practicing on the wires. You know, it'd take hell to get used to the wires and flying. Because when you see Batman, or you see any of these films, and even Superman, you see one or two men flying. But in that film, you had over 1,000 men flying and trying not to collide.
Ah, well, who wants to live forever?
Still talking about stunts, the fight. Sam's a terrific stuntman. And Prince Baron, you know, played by Timothy Dalton, was also a bloody natural fighter. Let them do it. Let's not employ the stuntmen. And so they did the bloody fight. It's wonderful. But that fight is real. They're going for one another. Mm-hmm. And those things that were coming, well, rather, which worried me, were hard plastic, the points that were coming. Give me the remote control. Mm-hmm. And I start making all these points come up on that revolving wheel. Well, they were quite dangerous. But those boys worked out the fight themselves. I mean, it really is a lot of brownie points for Flash Gordon and Prince Voltron here. It's bloody good. This book, by the way, the damn book you've done, this wonderful book.
I cannot
describe how much Flash Gordon means to me as a film. This book, the amount, the scenery, the history, things I never knew about, staggering, the costumes, makeup, wardrobe. I think that this book is a masterpiece in its own right.
Oh, thank you.
It is more than worthy of the film. It is, when I got it, I thought, well, is this going to be like most other little books and magazines? It took my eyes off. Put it down from page to page. And you've choreographed it. Perfectly. You're showing the costumes. You're showing the scenery. You're showing what the music is, and this, that, and the other, and all the problems, and different endings. And I think it's a masterpiece, the book. Flash Gordon is a comic strip work of art, but this book is a work of art. I'm so... Thank God you've done it. I mean, it's amazing. I keep reading it and reading it and reading it. I mean, it is the official... story. It covers the film brilliantly. It is a work of art. So you have to be congratulated.
Oh,
I just absolutely adore it. I mean, it's made me immensely happy. I cannot congratulate you enough. I'm like a child. Its colour, its vision, and the planning of the book, it is perfection. It is my idea of grace. I cannot thank you enough.
Oh, well, thank you, Brian, for being part of Flash Gordon and for being part of this book, because you know, you were one of the key people who had very good recall for the scenes you were in and the, you know, what happened on the production. I spoke to all of the people who are still with us, you know, for the book. You know, Mike worked with me extensively, but even Mike didn't know where the unmade Nicholas Rogue materials were. So I spent the best part of a year looking in film archives for the Nick Rogue version, the unmades, the deleted scenes, the model work, finding the photos of the model. The studios hadn't kept any of the photos, Brian, so there was very little from the studio to
look. Thank God you've done what you've done. You've resurrected it. You've saved it. You've made it wonderful filmic history. You've taken it a step beyond. I know of no science fiction film that is covered so brilliantly as this book covers Flash Gordon.
Oh, thank you.
You know, it's a masterpiece.
I think it's funny.
I hail you, therefore, you know, John, as a master. And I cannot thank you enough.
Oh, well, thank you, Brian. And it's a shame it's taken 40 years because, you know, a book hasn't allowed to be written for so many years and the rights were kind of all tied up for so many years for this book. But in some ways, perhaps it's good because when one finally did come out, it had everything in it that people wanted.
Gordon's alive!
Muhammad Ali said, you've got to find a gimmick. Until I found a gimmick, I was nobody. But I had to back it up, he said. And so now, wherever I go, people want me to say Gordon's alive. It's a cry, celebration of happiness, of achievement. Go for it. Gordon's alive. You're alive. Never mind the pandemic. Never mind diseases. Never mind tyranny. You're alive.
Can I ask you about Her Majesty? Because you were quoted in the papers as saying it's Her Majesty the Queen's favourite film. And can you tell me, is there any insight you could share? Don't feel you have to, because I know you're not really meant to discuss, are you, conversation with Royal Sebers. I'm not sure if that's for politicians. But,
but certainly the last one I did was, Boris Johnson adores it. And David Cameron, I was going there to discuss some expeditions. And I got there a bit earlier, number 10. And there was David Cameron. He just come from question time. And he said, oh, please. And he took me into the cabinet. And there was the cabinet. And I stood on a chair. Say it, for God's sake, say it. Gordon's alive. He said, oh, thank God. That'll wake the buggers up. It's the best thing that's ever happened to me, Flash Gordon. Wonderful. And when I see the film, I never get tired of it. I see things in it I've not seen before. Lots of extra things here and there.
And I imagine reading the book now give you an insight. You look again, perhaps, well, with the sets and the model. You
place things
work.
In this book that I didn't know about, that have answered a lot of questions. You know. But quite, I mean, absolutely, it's perfection. As I said, the direction, the style, the music. And now you're writing this book. Putting this book together is absolutely wonderful. Thank you. Thank you very much, John.
Well, thank you, Brian. I think it kind of, I always had these questions over the years. How did they make the spaceships fly? How did they do this? How did they do that? So this gave me the opportunity to find out all those questions. I had a million and one questions. And I thought how lucky I was to put it into a book to be able to find the answers with the photos.
Well, I think actors alive and were passed on saying a big, big thank you to you for your wonderful effort.
Well, thanks
ever so much.
And thanks to you, Brian Blessed, for keeping Gordon alive for 40 years and being a very good ambassador, the best ambassador for the film.
Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Thanks, John.
Copyright in Flash Gordon, the official story of the film podcast, is owned by John Walsh and Titan Books Limited, under license from King Features Incorporated. Audio from the film is courtesy of Studio Canal. This recording may not be reproduced in whole or in part without written permission from us. The views expressed within these podcasts do not necessarily reflect those of the associated companies or its employees. For further terms and conditions, please contact us at our Facebook page, Flash Gordon, the official story of the film.